Hey Blender users, today we're going to create this level of detail falloff slash camera culling. It can be useful for rocks, trees, asteroids, grain of sand, anything really. I was working on a new project that involved instancing with multiple LODs, and I was running into a problem. The transition between different LODs was very obvious as the camera approached and would leave a hard line. So using geometry nodes, I created this setup to soften the transition between high poly and low poly models. Let's get into it. Add in a grid and make sure you set the subdivisions high. The mesh needs to be dense for this effect to really work. Next, add a camera, and then we're going to create our camera culling object. Just add in a plane, rotate it 90 degrees, and make sure you go into viewport display and set it to wire, and then switch your render visibility to off. Add in an array modifier and set it to constant offset. And then you add in as many copies as you want. I'm going to make sure it's bigger than the mesh. Add in a simple deform and set it to taper. Make sure you switch it over to the right axis. And then go into camera view and scale it up so it fits just outside the bounds of the camera. Parent it to the camera, and then you can rename it and hide this object. Now move the camera close to the mesh, otherwise we're not going to see the effect. I've already created two collections here, and these are just going to represent high poly and low poly collections that we're going to use to instance across the mesh. On our grid object, create a new geometry nodes tree, add in a point distribute node and a point instance node, set it to collection, disable whole collection, and set this to your low poly collection. I'm just going to use a point scale node for demonstration purposes. In your node tree, you might have a much more complex setup. I'm going to duplicate the point instance and set this one to high poly. And here I can demonstrate to you that when you switch between two different collections that have the same number of objects, they keep their same position. So the torus is where the torus would be and the cone is where the cone would be in both high poly and low poly collections. At the beginning of the node tree, add in an object info, set it to relative and select the camera. Next, add in an attribute vector math node, change it from add to distance, and set A to vector and plug the object info location into A. Change B to position. In the result field, type distance, and that's going to create a new attribute. This is calculating the distance from the camera to the vertex points on the base mesh. Next, add an attribute math node, set it to divide, and set B to float. In A, put our distance attribute, and the result is going to be density. Next, put that density attribute into the point distribute node. And now you can control the falloff using the attribute math node that comes before the point distribute node. But obviously it's not right because it's inverted, so we're just going to flip that around. Add in a attribute color ramp and set density to both of these fields. Flip the colors around and there you have it. When it's set to black, it's no density. When it's set to pure white, it's set to the density maximum on your point distribute node. If you set it to constant, you can kind of see what's happening here, with the brighter areas of the ramp having more density. But I'm just going to set it to B-spline, and then I'm going to adjust it until it looks right. Now we got to use the camera cull object to eliminate any points that are outside of its bounds. After our point distribute node, add in an attribute proximity node and keep it set to faces. Add in a new object info node and select the camera cull object and put that into the target of the proximity node. In the distance field, create a new attribute called camera cull, and then add in a point separate node after this. This will eliminate the points beyond the camera cull object. Now add an attribute math node, set it to subtract, and then put your camera cull into A, and then result is going to be a new one called camera mask. And then on the point separate node, add this camera mask attribute into the field section, and then adjust the slider to change how far out you want the bounds to be growing. Now we need to make the high resolution version of our meshes spawn in closer to the camera. Before the two point instance nodes, add a point separate, and then after them, add a join geometry node. Before that new point separate node, add an attribute math set to subtract. In A, type in density and result, add a new attribute and name it LOD0. In the point separate, add in that new LOD0. Now you can adjust where one collection ends and the other begins. Finally, add in an attribute random, set this to add, and set this to LOD0. This is what lets you adjust how hard or soft the divide is between the two collections. If you don't like going into the node tree every time you want to make a change, you can plug in values from your node tree into the group input, and then you'll be able to adjust them in the modifier panel on the right here. With all those set up, I can make changes so much quicker, and better yet, I can import this node tree into other projects already set up and ready to go. If you want to keep your base mesh, all you need to do is add a join geometry node at the end and add in a switch node, and then you can link that to an input, and you should also be able to just change that in the modifiers panel. And that's all for this video. I hope to get this into a much larger project, which I will be creating a tutorial on, and I'm very excited to show you what it's going to be. Thanks for watching. Remember to like and subscribe.